हरे कृष्णा। क्वेश्चन, इज रिलीजन मेड बाय मैन और बाय गॉड? आंसर, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट वी मीन बाय द वर्ड रिलीजन। इफ यू लुक एट इट एटिमोलॉजिकली, रिलीजन कम्स फ्रॉम द वर्ड रिलीजियो, विच मीन्स टू कनेक्ट, टू लिंक, टू बाइंड ह्यूमैनिटी विद डिविनिटी। सो व्हेन वी लुक एट दैट प्रिंसिपल, रिलीजन at its original core has come from God. God has himself come or has sent his messengers and has given books like the Bible, the Quran, the Bhagavad Gita, which guide us to come back to him. So those people who live according to the wisdom given in these books, they are the followers of God, they become linked with God, and subsequently those people came to be known as belonging to a particular religion. Now, in the original sense, the wisdom has come from God and the method for linking back with him has come from God. But over the centuries, over the millennia, often many undesirable and unscriptural things have come into religion. And because of that, much of what is going on in the name of religion has not come from God, it has come from man. So the original principle and process of linking back with God is something which has come from God, but the many accretions which are deviations, which are inappropriate things, which actually do not connect us back with God, they are not what has come from God, they are man-made. So therefore, rather than rejecting a religion entirely as having come from man, or following religion uncritically as if it all has come from God, we have to actually study scripture, understand God's message, understand God's process for coming back to him, and then follow religion in a way by which we can actually become connected with God. So religion in Sanskrit word, which is often used as equivalent for religion, is dharma. Now, dharma originally means, etymologically it means dhriyate, dharyate, that which maintains, that which sustains, that is called dharma. So this root, at its root, dharma is actually, it means to sustain, that which is something which sustains the existence of something, that which is the very innate nature of something else. So just as it is the nature of fire to be hot, it is the nature of water to be liquid, it is the nature of sugar to be sweet, similarly it is our nature to love and serve. So wherever we living beings exist, we want to love, we want to, and we want to express that love through service. So our dharma in that sense is to love and to serve, and this, at this level, if you understand the word dharma, it is definitely something which is innate to us. We could say it has been made by God, because that is a part of our very fabric, of the very fabric of our being. So that is made by God, and that nature, so there is our inner nature to love and serve. Now where do I direct that nature to love and serve so that we can be truly happy? That is meant to be directed towards God, and through God towards all living beings. So in this way, the process by which our innate nature gets directed in a way that it brings lasting happiness, that process is actually religion. So our nature is purified and directed towards God, by which we get lasting happiness. So those processes which enable us to develop love for God, they are actually religion in the true sense. So in the Srimad Bhagavatam, one of the most important books in the Indian scripture, Vedic scriptures, it says, it doesn't talk about this religion being greater or that religion being greater. It says that religion which enables people to develop love for God, that is the highest dharma. Savai pumsam paro dharmo yato bhaktira dhokshaje ahaitukiya pratihata yayatma su prasidati. So that which helps us to develop pure love, ahaitukiya pratihata, which is unmotivated and uninterrupted, that is the perfect path of religion. So rather than saying that rejecting religion as man-made or embracing religion uncritically as God-made, we study scripture, understand the purpose of religion to channelize our innate nature and to help us find lasting happiness, and then follow a religion that helps us to develop love for God. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.